So this is what I saw earlier this week, and I was like, what is that? And so I did some digging, and I'm just a little slow to the bus. It's not brand new to everybody like yesterday. So a few people by invite were put into this test group, and then I just started seeing this a couple days ago. So I was like, what is a LinkedIn newsletter? So what I'll do is I can just bump through some of the documentation, and I'm going to show you a newsletter that I subscribe to just to see what it looks like, and we can talk about maybe some of the differences between what LinkedIn calls a LinkedIn newsletter and what we think of when we hear newsletter, when you know you just get those one-off emails. And I actually received an email of a newsletter right before the hangout started, so I can show that too. All right, so this is where you'll see the invitation to follow a newsletter. So newsletters on LinkedIn, I mean, I don't want to go through all this stuff. You can just Google it, you know, newsletter on LinkedIn back and reach this on your own time. Just a couple thoughts here is, oh, let's see here. How do I view which newsletter I'm subscribed to? You can't. I thought that was kind of funny. let's see. So what happens is, it's like, remember LinkedIn Pulse was a big deal? And then you would publish an article and everyone got notified and it was like amazing and all the rage, and so everyone's doing Pulse articles. And then the notification stopped and then you started sharing the Pulse article and then you see it and then it hits the link so it doesn't go anywhere. It's like, oh my gosh, what are we doing? We're chasing our tail. And so it seems like LinkedIn values content on their platform, and what they're doing then is Pulse kind of got renamed to articles, LinkedIn articles. And now, so there's a few people, it's by invite only, so you cannot apply. It's by invitation only. Can create a newsletter, and it's like a category almost. Like you can create an article, and just, it can be an article, or you can create an article and say it's part of my newsletter. So you can create a newsletter, write an article, and then that article is in that newsletter. Does that make sense? Okay, cool. So I don't have the access to create a newsletter, so I'm kind of just relying on the documentation. So newsletters work with articles, it's by invite only, and let's see here. So this is what an article that's part of a newsletter is going to look like. So I'm gonna unsubscribe. So they've got like a banner there, that's the name of the newsletter, not the person. And you know what, just really quick, let's go to Caroline's. Oh, there's a Caroline in the chat. It's not the same Caroline, because that would just make me cry, because that'd be hilarious. So if we go to Caroline, we can't see, like, there's articles here, but there's no big, hey, I have a newsletter, which I thought was interesting. And then you can go here, so if you do click her, like you see articles, you can see these are, it looks like a normal article. It doesn't say, at least right now, that these are all newsletters. So if you click one of the articles, you'll see though that this is a newsletter. There's the logo for the newsletter. There's the title. There's the description. It's weekly. Here's how many people have subscribed to it. Ooh, that looks clickable. Let's see what happens. Oh, shut up. I haven't done that yet. That's a nice list. It is interesting. So you can maybe get an idea for who. Jeez, are you serious? I'm freaking out. Oh, live. Wow, that is fascinating. So, that's interesting. That is really, really interesting. Yeah, I wonder how far you can scroll down. Wow, that is very interesting. I haven't seen it yet. So you can, so there's this is about the newsletter, scroll down to the bottom. So you see here there's a video, I mentioned that because I'm going to show you the email in a second. Mm-hmm. Video, published by, and then you can see, let's see, at the very bottom here, there's another sort of line with the newsletter branding. So if I push, I move this thing over here, you might see that. Subscribe, and there's a little notification down here. You will be notified when there is a new article in this newsletter. And so let's go to notifications. So there's two notifications I'm seeing, let's see here. So new from Caroline, in Working Together 2020, flexible work will no longer be a woman's issue. So I click that, and then taken to, there it is. And before the hangout just started, I was thinking, based off of the notification, that this is it, that's the extent of the notification. But I got an email, let me just quick share that with you, because I was pretty surprised to see that. One moment. All right, sharing my actual email there. Can you see that? Mm-hmm. All right, so this is what it looks like. So newsletter on LinkedIn, Working Together by Caroline. I can click her profile there. Title, there's that guy. There you go, this is like their kind of boilerplate. View media, an original article. Just by saying, like, there's a video on the article, but it's not in the newsletter. And then from there, it's kind of the same format as you see on the LinkedIn article, minus the video, yeah. I didn't expect to see that, so I was very surprised. I can unsubscribe. Mm-hmm. I can join the conversation, so there's a call to action there to join the comments. And let's see. Yeah, so kind of pulling back a step, I feel like this is more for high-quality publishers who continually produce high-quality content where the following makes sense, and the material that they're sending out is, like, you know, meets whatever their unique business objections are. But yeah, it goes out, create an article associated with a newsletter, goes out to subscribers by email, and then they get a notification. I think it's also worth saying what Tracy said in a comment earlier in the week, that the scary thing here is that you're totally renting your audience from LinkedIn and relying on LinkedIn. So the moment that LinkedIn says, we're going to sunset this feature, this gal's, whatever, many, many, many subscribers to this material, it could be over. And that's a big liability. Now, she could be taking the initiative, because she can view the subscribers. She can take the initiative to say, hey, let's connect. I see you're following my newsletter. And then take an email and have an opt-in like that. That might be a safer route, and it might take more work. But it's an option. But also very potentially risky, or a lot of liabilities if you're relying on that one thing there. So there we have it. Anybody, any thoughts, comments on there?
Yeah, the only thought I have is that LinkedIn is really putting a strategy out there to keep people inside of LinkedIn, mm-hmm. Go outside of LinkedIn. And the worry I have with this feature is that they will make it a paid feature, like email, and that you have to pay by subscriber, essentially.
It's totally, they can do whatever they want.
Yeah.
it's a possibility. I'm wondering how many people are going to get access to that. You know, I wonder if it's going to, like, the LinkedIn influencers in the blue, in, that's been around for a long time, it's still by invite only. Mm-hmm. And so I'm curious if they'll kind of do that same thing where there's a who's who and you need to know somebody, or somebody's looking for high quality publishers, to be given access to that to protect everyone from being invited to a million newsletters that are garbage and no one cares about.